core things, aren't they? How do we make people see humanity? And we create what we create because we want to distance ourselves from suffering. And I think that's huge in our society right now, is that we have huge suffering. And a lot of people's response is that I've got to distance myself from this suffering, because what am I going to do about it? And I tried to bring my sister here tonight, and she struggled. She said, I can't, that's not my kind of thing. My other sister said, well, that's because she's in the rugby club, and the rugby club are full of far rights. And it was interesting, I said, how am I going to get to them? You know, so it's kind of my sister distance, you know, it's this distancing is so powerful. And then how do we bring people to see humanity when all people want to actually be doing many times distance myself, please? It's too much.
Absolutely, and I mean, that's a brilliant thought, and I love the observation about the distance. And it's interesting because when I talk about violence, whether I'm talking with kids in a rough school or if I'm talking at a CBE conference in Abu Dhabi, it always comes down to the root of violence is isolation and suffering. And that's violence from the scale of the Holocaust to some kid bullying another kid on Facebook. It's a combination of isolation and suffering, and those things are cyclical. When you isolate yourself spiritually, intellectually, emotionally from other human beings, you suffer. And when you suffer, you want to isolate yourself more. So you get in this cycle that it can be incredibly difficult to get out of. The other part about the distancing is that, yes, it is a natural thing for us to want to distance ourselves from suffering. It's uncomfortable for us to suffer. It's uncomfortable for us to see other human beings suffer. So I think it's important to talk about the inevitability of bearing witness to suffering. And it's something that I've kind of dawned upon recently is a universal truth, which has been around, you know, everybody's understood for a long, long time. But in my case, I'm a Buddhist, I understand it from a point of the Dharma, is that we will bear witness to other people's suffering. It's not a question of whether we will or not. The question is whether we will bear witness via compassion or aggression. Because if you try to just pretend that suffering's not happening, I don't want to hear it, blah, 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 that person who's suffering is going to become very aggressive. And you will, one way or another, bear witness to that. So it's actually a beautiful thing to have that option, to have that capability to say, I understand your suffering, let me bear witness to it in a context of compassion, and let me offer to help and do everything I can to help your healing process. And when we can understand those very simple dynamics, it's all cyclical things, and it's mechanical almost how it works. When we can understand those mechanics, it really it empowers us to not only heal others and to make the world a better place, but it empowers us to ultimately find our own happiness and to